فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
And many other reasons that the scholars mentioned. The طبقات المدلسين. The مدلسين have levels, and there are five levels. There are five levels of مدلسين. The first type, and Ibn Hajar is the one who mentioned this, is called طبقات المدلسين. There are five types. He wrote a book in this regard, this issue, Ibn Hajar. One is من لم يوصف بذلك إلا نادرا. Somebody who is not referred to as a مدلس, except rare. And he's who? Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari. Is rare, nadir, very rare. The third type is من احتمل الأئمة تدليسا. The second one is those whose tadlis is taken on board. The scholars meaning when I say the tadlis is taken on board, meaning the scholars have accepted their tadlis. The hadith is being accepted even with the tadlis in it. The scholars have texted it. Such as who? Sufyan ibn Uyayna. Such as who? Sufyan ibn Uyayna. Why would they do that? Because Sufyan ibn Uyayna only does tadlis of thiqat. The only people who drops out are people who are thiqah. When he was asked, every time it was reliable people. And we took it before, when he dropped out who? Abdurrazzaq ibn Hammam al-San'ani and Ma'mar ibn Rashid. Huh? To get to Zuhri, that's how he did it. Are you with me? Good job. So those people are too thiqah. Abdurrazzaq ibn Hammam al-San'ani is thiqah and Ma'mar ibn Rashid is thiqah. So Sufyan ibn Uyayna was known, he only dropped that thiqah. So he's one that's accepted, even that there's tadlis in it. Or his tadlis is very little, such as Thawri, rahimahullah, Sufyan al-Thawri. It's the second one. Thawri, rahimahullah ta'ala, because of his imamah, because of how high he was a person, and noble he was, and his tadlis was very little, scholars also, they accepted that. The third type is, من أكثر من التدليس مع ثقتي. Somebody whose tadlis is a lot, but he's still a thiqah. He's still a thiqah. Are you with me? Is Abi Zubayr al-Makki, مثلاً. Even though there's khilaf regarding his reliability, but Abi Zubayr al-Makki. And four is من أكثر من التدليس عن الضعفاء والمجاهيل. Somebody who done a lot of tadlis from people who are unknown and people who are weak. From people who are unknown and people who are weak. Fifth one is من ضعف بأمر آخر سوى التدليس. The fifth one is a person who is weakened due to something that is other than tadlis. He was weakened due to something other than tadlis. He is a mudallis, but other things made him weak. The first type of people who have tadlis, the five that I mentioned, the first two types is accepted. The first two types are accepted. They accept the ones that are rarely do tadlis, which is the first one, is like Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari. And the second one is those who do tadlis, but they only do it from the people of thiqah, reliability, like Sufyan ibn Uyayna. The third one, which is the tabaqatu thalitha, the third type. As for the first, fourth type of tabaqat, the third type, which is the people who tadlis are, and they are thiqah and they do tadlis, like for example, Abi Zubayr al-Makki, the scholars, they dispute each other on views, and there are four views regarding that, the third type. The first group, they said, we're not going to take it. So that's the third. The first two is accepted. Brothers, what are we talking about here? حكم الرواية المدلس. What is the ruling of the narration of the مدلس? I said the first two طبقة are accepted. The third type, what did I say? There's a khilaf whether it should be accepted. There's a dispute. And there's four views regarding it. I didn't say five, I said four. Did I say five? Four views. The fourth view is أن يروي جماعة يرى جماعة من الفقهاء وأصحاب الحديث أن الخبر المدلس غير مقبول مطلقا. It's not accepted at all. That's the first view. The second view is ويرى جمع من أهل العلم أن الخبر المدلس مقبول مطلقا. The second type is that it is accepted generally. It's the opposite to the first one, right? The third view is what? وَقَالَ آخَرُونَ بِالتَّفْصِيلِ. The third view is that they saw a tafsil. It has to be explained. No. If the Mudallis, he narrates it with a بِالسِّمَعِ, such as سَمِعْتُ, or he says حَدَثَنَا, it is مَقْبُول مُحْتَجٌ بِهِ. It's مقبول and it's accepted and it's dependent. وَإِلْ رَوَى, if he narrates it بِلَفْضٍ مُحْتَمَلْ, if it's مُحْتَمَلْ كَعَنْ فَلَا يُقْبَلْ. And this is the call of who? Shafi'i ibn Salah, Nawawi ibn Hajar, and other than them. Are you with me? The fourth is what? Another group of people, they said there's a tafsir. But their tafsir was not the same as the tafsir as the third group. What did they say? They said, if the person in urifa min al-mudallisi, if the mudallis is known, and no la yarwi illa al-thiqa, if he's known to not do tadlis except of a thiqa, then they said, فَيُقْبَلُ بِأَيِّ سِغَةٍ كَالَ, whichever way he does it is accepted. Are you with me? If he's known to just drop out a person who is what? Thiqah. Then they said, whichever form he narrates it in, it doesn't matter whether he says, قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا عَنْ, and it doesn't matter. It's accepted. وَإِنْ كَانَ الْمُدَلِّسُ يُدَلِّسُ عَنْ ثِقَةٍ وَغَيْرِ ثِقَةٍ. But if he does it with thiqah and other than a thiqah, فَلَا يُقْبَلُ إِلَّا إِذَا صَرَحَ بِالتَّحْدِيثِ. They said, we not take it unless he does تَصْرِيحُ التَّحْدِيثِ. Like he's sariha, saraha, he mentions it. Clear. سَمِعْتُ أَخْبَرَنَا أَنْبَأِ. That's what they said. What about the fourth and the fifth? As for the fourth and the fifth, the fourth one, فَلَا خِلَافَ, there's no خِلَاف فِي عَدَمِ قَبُولِهِ إِلَّا مَعَ تَصْرِيحِ بِالسِّمَعِ. The fourth one, are you guys with me which I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I went back to the original. The fourth one, which is the one who only does tadlis from the du'afa and the majahil, there's no خِلَاف amongst the scholars of hadith, except unless he mentions that حَدَثَنَا أَخْبَرَنَا, they don't take it. The fourth one. The fifth one, they're not accepted even if they do تصريح السمع, even if they say حَدَثَنَا أَخْبَرَنَا. Are you with me? Because they're weak generally. They're just weak people. As for the third view that I mentioned, if you guys remember, the fourth, the third type, which is the people who narrate من أكثر من التدليس مع ثقتي, and is a thiqa, such as Abu Zubayr al-Makki. I said four views came out of that one, right? Huh? Which view is the strongest? The third view of that one is the strongest, which is the view of Shafi'i, Ibn Salah, Nawawi, and Ibn Hajar is the strongest. Which is what? If إن كان المدلس يروي بلفظ السماع أو الحديث, he narrates it with السماع أو الحديث, it is accepted and it's dependent on. If he uses an or not, it's not accepted. And the Shafi'i's view, Ibn Salah's view, Nawawi's view, Ibn Hajar's view is the strongest. Wallahu a'lam.
We took the mardud, the rejected hadith. We took if the rejection occurs, or the rejection occurs from two angles or two reasons. Imma as-saqtu fi sanad am at'anu fi rawi. The chain of narration is disconnected, or the narrator of the hadith is what? Or the narrator of the hadith is criticized. Okay? We're on the last type of as-saqtu fi sanad, the disconnection that occurs in the hadith. Because we said the saqt is how many types? Two. Just like the way at-ta'anu fi rawi is two types. As-saqtu fi sanad is what? Imma zahir, amma wadih, and khafi. We took the zahir, or the wadih. We are now on the khafi. We also took the mudallis, we took, which is the zahir. Which is the khafi. We took that one. We're on the last one, which is called al-mursal al-khafi. It's called al-mursal al-khafi. Mursal al-khafi is, it means an yarwi rawi. It is that a narrator would narrate. Ammal laqiyahu, somebody who he has met. Or asarahu, or he lived with him at the same era, time. Ma lam yasma' minhu, that which he hasn't heard from him. Bilafdin, in a wordy, yahtabilu sima'a wa ghayrahu kaqala. He will use the word qala. The example for that is ما رواه ابن ماجه, that which ابن ماجه has narrated through the chain of عمر بن عبد العزيز, who narrated from عقبة بن عامر. Who narrated from عقبة بن عامر. where he said رحم الله حارسة الحارسي. This hadith, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, we know he hasn't met Uqba. He hasn't met him. He has not met him, as Imam al-Mizzi mentioned in his Kitab al-Atrafi. But did they live at the same era? Yes. How can one realize and recognize the Irsal al-Khafi, the Mursal al-Khafi? How can one identify it and know it? There are two ways to know it. The first one is Nassun, a text. بعض الأئمة, from the, some of the scholars, على أن هذا الراوية, stating that this narrator لم يلقى من حدث عنه, that he has not met the person who he's narrating from, or he hasn't heard from him at all. Two, إخباره informing عن نفسه. He informs of himself بأنه لم يلقى. He informs his own self بأنه لم يلقى من حدث عنه. He informs it himself, saying, I have not met this person which I'm narrating from, or I haven't heard anything from this person. Okay? Those are the two ways to identify it. The hadith which is مرسل الخفي is ضعيف لأنه من نوع المنقطع, because it's a disconnected chain of narration. One of the best books to find this topic and to study it a bit more in details is the book written by Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi. It's called At-Tafsili. Khatib al-Baghdadi authored a book. He called it At-Tafsili Limubhamil Marasili. Limubhamil Marasili. At-Tafsili Limubhamil Marasili. You can find in that book. Now, inshallah, we're going to move on to the Qawl of Hafiz Ibn Hajar. Ibn Hajar then says, so we've studied as-saqt fi sanad. The first reason why a hadith is rejected is because it's disconnected. We're now going to move on to the next type, which is at-ta'nu fi rawi, the narrator to be criticized. Thumma ta'nu, the criticism. Imma an yakuna. Remember, we said that the criticism is what? The criticism occurs in what? Either في عدالة الراوي, regarding his عدالة or his ضبط, his عدالة or his ضبط. Each one has five. The عدالة has five and the ضبط has five. Let's remind ourselves again. The عدالة is what? Five. The first one is الكذب, lying. التهمة بالكذب, to be suspected as a liar. الفسق, to be a فاسق. البدعة, to be a innovator. Al-jahala, you are unknown. That's at-ta'nu, criticism regarding adala. The next one is at-ta'nu, criticism that is directed at al-dabt, his memory. What is it? Fuhshul ghalat. Al-ghafla, mukhalafatu thiqat. Al-wahmu, su'ul hifz. We're going to take each one, inshallah ta'ala. Which one are we going to start with? The Sheikh says, ثُمَّ طَعْنُ, the criticism, إِمَّا أَن يَكُونَ, it can be لِكَذْبِ الرَّاوِي, because the narrator is a liar. The criticism is because of his lying. What does lying mean? لغةً, linguistically, it means نَقِيضُ الصِّدْق, is the opposite to truth. It's the opposite to truth. The Arabs say كَذِبَ يَكْذِبُ كَذِبًا وَكِذْبًا وَكِذْبَةٌ وَكِذَّابًا. Look at the Kitab إصلاح المنطق and the لسان العرب. إصطلاحاً, what does it mean? Technically, it means هو الإخبار, it is to inform. عن الشيء is to inform a matter. على خلاف ما هو, opposite to what it really is. It is to inform something to the opposite of its reality. Whether you say it deliberately or you're joking, it's a lie. Whether you say it deliberately or even if you say it by accident, even by accident, it's called kadhib. It's a lie in the Arabic language. So whether it's amdan or sahwan, we don't condition for a speech, for us to say that this speech is a lie, for it to come from a person deliberately. فَلَا يُسْتَرَطُ. We do not condition. لتسمية الكلام to call the speech a lie huh? كونه صدر من قائله عمدا by it having to come out from the person deliberately no بل مجرد الإخبار just the mere fact that the person informs us of something which is the opposite to the reality is a lie that's enough for us to say that it's a lie where is the evidence for that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said من كذب anyone who lies about me متعمدا deliberately what does that show us that there is a lie that is not deliberately صحيح anyone who lies about me deliberately فليتبوأ مقعده من النار but what's the benefit of this hadith that if your lying is not deliberate you don't fall under this hadith meaning the warning is not regarding you huh the warning is regarding who a person who does it deliberately but it's still a lie what you said is still a lie na'am whereas the mu'tazila they say the mu'tazila which are a deviated sect yarawna ishtirat al-amdiyah they say that they condition that the person said it deliberately so the speech can become a lie that's what they say and that's something that goes against what Ahl al-Sunnah say what is the ruling regarding the person who lies about the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ajma'a it's a unanimous agreement consents من يعتد بقوله من المسلمين anyone whose speech is taken into consideration from the Muslims على تحريم that it's haram الكذب على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that lying about the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم is haram والحكم بأنه and it's also the ruling is what that it's a major sin من كبائر الذنوب is from the major sins because of the hadith which is متواتر which the prophet said من كذب علي متعمدا anyone who lies about me deliberately فليتبوأ مقعده من النار let him prepare his place in the hellfire Imam Abu Ma'ali al-Juwayni rahimahullah who's Abu Ma'ali al-Juwayni Imam al-Haramin whose kitab al-Waraqat we're studying currently as well right now he narrated from his father's called Muhammad his father made takfir of anyone who places a hadith deliberately he said he's a kafir But the son, he said that view is very weak to make a kafir of a person. And he said about his father, وَأَنَّوْ هَفْوَةُ الْعَظِيمَةِ That my father to say this is a very big mistake. Because he said nobody from the a'imma, nobody from the scholars have said that. In the madhab, الشافعية. ذهبي رحمه الله, he brought from Ibn al-Jawzi قوله, وَلَا رَيْبَ أَنَّ الْكَذِبَ عَلَى اللَّهِ That without a doubt, that lying about Allah and His Messenger في تحليل حرام أو تحريم حلال كفر محض Ibn al-Jawzi said لكن to lie about Allah and His Messenger in making halal that which they made haram or making haram that which they made halal then this is كفر محض this is a clear cut كفر وإنما الشأن but the matter is في الكذب عليه فيما سوى ذلك but the matter is lying about both of them in a matter which is not making halal that which they made haram or haram that which they made halal. Okay? Also, the speech that the Karramiyyah are a deviated sect. They ascribe themselves to a man by the name of Muhammad ibn Karram al-Sijtani. They see the permissibility of ibahat wad' al-hadith. They see the permissibility of fabricating and making up a hadith. Al-mutadammina, that what? That consists in it, للترغيب في الطاعة والتنفير من المعصية. That brings the people to the obedience of Allah, and that also pushes away the people from what? The disobedience of who? Allah. So they said those type of hadiths, very good, no problem. And they start, they claim, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا لَرَاجِعُونَ They say that the hadith, that the Prophet said, مَنْ كَذَبَ عَلَيَّ Anyone who lies about me, on me. They said, that the Prophet said, مَنْ كَذَبَ عَلَيَّ And they said, that's not what we do. We don't lie about the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. We lie for the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. إِنَّا نَكْذِبُ لَهُ وَلَسْنَا نَكْذِبُ عَلِيهِ We lie for him, we don't lie about him. صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this is a kalam which is mutahafit. It's kalam which has no basis, it's just childish. And it's really, to be honest, it doesn't even deserve to be refuted. وَهُوَ أَقَلُّ مِنْ أَن يُرَدَّ It's too pathetic for it to be even talked and spoken about. The message doesn't need anyone to lie for him. He doesn't need anyone to lie to spread his da'wah alayhi salatu wasalam and his religion.